In this video, you will learn to create stem and leaf plots in StatCrunch. The data set I'll be using is called Asking Prices for 4-Bedroom Homes in Bryan, College Station, Texas. The data set was collected in order to compare 4-bedroom homes listed for sale in 2 adjoining cities of Bryan, Texas and College Station, Texas. Using a real estate website, 15 homes were randomly selected from 4-bedroom homes listed for sale in Bryan, Texas, and 15 homes were randomly selected from 4-bedroom homes listed for sale in College Station, Texas. The price per square footage column will be the only column used in this video. This column contains the selling price in dollars of each home divided by the home's square footage. Let's begin by creating a stem and leaf plot for the price per square footage column. To do so, under the graph menu, choose stem and leaf. Select the price per square footage column and click compute. The resulting stem and leaf plot shown has 4 stems with leaves for 28 of the 30 homes in the data set. The other 2 homes with prices of $300 and $488 per square foot are displayed on the high listing due to the default outlier trimming. The decimal point is shown to be 2 places to the right of the colon, separating the stems from the leaves. So the 9 on the 1 stem represents a value of $190 per square foot. Equivalently, the value of 190 can be obtained by multiplying the leaf value of 9 by the displayed leaf unit of 10 to get a product of 90, which is then appended to the stem value of 1. This rounded value of 190 corresponds to the $187 per square foot value in the second row of the data set. Rounding values is common in stem and leaf plots in order to produce a reasonable display. StatCrunch also allows the user to change the leaf unit to provide a more or less detailed summary of the data. To do so, under Options, choose Edit. This takes us back to the original window where we created the plot. In this window, StatCrunch has other options for the user to customize their plot. In the Leaf Unit box, I'm going to choose 1. I'll click Compute. The resulting stem and leaf plot has a smaller leaf unit of 1, which increases the number of stems required to cover the range of the data, excluding the outliers. The decimal place is now 1 place to the right of the colon. The value of $187 per square foot is shown directly in the plot without rounding. It is shown as a 7 on the 18 stem. This value can be understood as the 7 leaf value multiplied by the leaf unit of 1 to get a product of 7, which is then appended to the stem value of 18. StatCrunch only trims extreme outliers off the plot and places them on a separate low and high listing as necessary. To change how outliers are handled, back under Options, choose Edit. Under Outlier Trimming, I'm going to select None. This will not trim any data values from the plot. The Mild and Extreme option can be used to make the procedure more aggressive in identifying outliers for trimming. I'll click Compute. The plot now has stems that cover the entire data range, and it includes the values of $300 per square foot and $488 per square foot in the plot.